Hello, my name is Nate, and today we are going to look at how to configure batteries to monitor them precisely. But before doing any configuring, let's look at the two ways you can monitor your batteries. The first option is full battery monitoring, which relies on observing voltage and current passing through a shunt. This allows you to get the maximum precision state of charge of your battery. The second option is voltage-only battery monitoring. This way is less precise, but it does not require the use of a shunt, so it's easier to configure. When determining whether to go with voltage-only battery monitoring or full battery monitoring, the most important factor is battery type. In case you have a lithium-type battery, you have to go with full battery monitoring because voltage of lithium-type batteries is always constant, so that way the voltage-only battery monitoring will not be precise enough. In the case of an engine battery, it is enough to have voltage-only battery monitoring because the battery is constantly kept at full charge by the alternator. Let's begin with voltage-only battery monitoring. To add a new battery, we navigate PICO to the menu, then we select Devices and Batteries. Here we select Add New. First option lets us name the battery. The second option lets us select the type of battery we have. The next option, capacity C20, is the full capacity of our current battery, in our case 100 amp hours. These two options we do not touch. Voltmeter. We select one of the inputs from our other devices. If we have a temperature sensor in our battery compartment, we select the temperature sensor that is connected to the devices. That is it for voltage battery monitoring. For full battery monitoring, we have to configure the battery a bit more. If the manufacturer of the battery has provided capacity C10 and capacity C5 information, please add them to the given options. For full battery monitoring, we have to select ammeters. Here we have to select our shunt, which is connected to the device. If you have more shunts connected to the system, please select the required one. After we have configured our battery for full battery monitoring, we have to set the range for the current that passes through the shunt. In our case, we have range set to 100 amps. That means if range is set to 100 amps, if current that is passing through the battery will be 50 amps, the bar will be 50% filled. For the SC303 shunt, we recommend setting range to 300 amps, and for the SC503 shunt, we recommend the range to be set to 500 amps. For more advanced battery monitoring, we also have advanced settings. TTG SOC minimum means that the PICO will display state of charge 0% while the battery has still 20% of life left. If you have a battery that has a separate battery monitoring system, make sure to set this setting to 0%, so values on the PICO and other monitoring systems will match. For display type, we recommend using the detailed option because that gives you also the amp hours left in the battery. Sometimes when a battery is first configured, there may be a problem for PICO to determine a correct starting point, and it can display a 75% for instance, when the battery is actually closer to 100%. This happens because the first voltage reading from which PICO determines the first state of charge of the battery may be affected by a voltage drop in case there are consumers running. This is easily resolvable by holding the two middle buttons and setting the battery to full 100%. In this case, you have to make sure that the battery is actually at 100%. If you would like to know more, please check our other videos. Or if you have specific questions, please contact us at support@simarine.net, and we will see you next time.